Hello, everyone, and welcome to Gastonia, North Carolina. You're watching the live broadcast from Gaston Day School between the home team, Gaston Day, against the visiting team, First Assembly. First Assembly comes into tonight's game leading the conference. And Gaston Day School has a great record as well. They only have one loss at home this season, having suffered that one loss just about a week or so ago against rival Northside Christian. So we expect this game to be a very tight matchup all the way to the end and a hotly contested game right from the tip. Quite a few college coaches here in the building to watch some of these players. Got several notable players that we'll be watching tonight, and we're very excited about some of the matchups. And we'll get into all of that in just a few moments, so if you'll bear with us, we will come back when we get closer to the tip just in a couple of minutes. So thanks a lot. So hello, everyone. Welcome back. We're live here from Gastonia, North Carolina. We're coming to you from the beautiful campus of Gaston Day School in Gastonia, North Carolina. I am Marcus Shockley with Netcast Sports. We appreciate everyone joining us tonight. Looks like we're about to have the tip, and it's going to be between number 24, Nico Payne, the 6'7" junior, against number 1, Aiden Richard, and for Gaston Day in the home whites. Aiden Richard is 6'10" and committed to Belmont Abbey, so we've got two college prospects, one college commit already here at the tip, and we've got several more to get to as the game progresses. We appreciate everyone for joining us tonight here on netcastsports.com. You can watch this replay, this live broadcast on Netcast Sports, as well as our upcoming games. And we will talk about that, I'm sure, as the game continues, but looks like we've got whatever the delay was taken care of, and we're about to have the tip, so we'll settle in for a good game here. Excited to get this one underway. Looks like Gaston Day wins the tip right to Derek McKnight, running the point, number 4. He wants to drive, find Trevor Anderson. He feeds it inside to James Lewis. Lewis over the top and scores, and right away the 6'8" junior puts his team on the board, and Gaston Day takes the first lead of the night. So First Assembly now their first chance at running their offense, working the ball around. There's Todorovic. Almost loses the ball, but it lands in the hands of Matt Wheat. Wheat drives, and he's going to draw the foul and go to the line. So Matt Wheat, the 6'1" senior, has a chance to stop the clock here in the first quarter and give his team a chance to get into the scoring column. Wheat is actually, as I said, the second leading scorer on the team, just over 16 points a game. And we've got another delay here, and I don't know if this would almost work against Wheat as he attempts to shoot his free throw. It's sort of the effect of icing the kicker in football where you get a delay. So hopefully he'll get a chance to get his shots up in just a moment, as the officials work something out here at the scorer's table. And looks like we've got that straightened out. So here we go. Matt Wheat's got his first chance here. He's going to be shooting 2 from the line. First shot good. Rebound off the second missed free throw by Aiden Richard. He's going to give it up to McKnight. McKnight pushing ahead to Anderson. Finds Kazeel in the corner. Kazeel's shot no good. Rebound there by Marquise Beasley, number 5. He's going to push the ball. Stops. Nice little stutter step. Splits the defense. And unfortunately, he had nowhere to go once he got into the basket. And that's going to be a turnover. And Gaston Day now with a chance to run their offense once again. So early on here, Gaston Day with a slim lead. We are just getting underway here. Derek McKnight bringing the ball up against number 14, Charles Minland. Now over to Adam Kazeel. Back to McKnight. Charles Minland playing defense is definitely one of the players that colleges are looking at. He holds currently 12 Division I offers and several colleges in the gym tonight. And here's another player colleges are looking at, Trevor Anderson. Blocked there by Beasley, I think. Able to recover his shot. Gets it over to Kazeel. Kazeel shot too strong, and now here's Beasley looking to push it. And he finds Wheat. Wheat tries to launch it, but Derek McKnight repays the block favor. He's going to drive, split the two defenders up and under. No good. James Lewis tried to get his hands on it. It looks like it's going to go out of bounds, and it's going to stay with Gaston Day. So Lewis will get a chance to inbound it under his own basket. Nico Payne trying to create some defense there underneath, and that's going to be either a five-second call or stepping on the line. I kind of quick for a five-second call, so we're going to have to. But whatever it was, good defense there by First Assembly, and now they've got a chance to run their offense. And Todorovic, he's over to Payne, now back over to Wheat. Wheat being checked up by Anderson, who wants to drive him down, and that's going to be a turnover as Wheat tried to feed Nico Payne inside, and it was just too far out of reach for the big man. And another turnover early here. It's kind of, I don't know if it's nerves or just both teams trying to find their offense, but early on here we are seeing a lot of turnovers, a lot of sloppy play. Anderson driving, shovel pass inside to Aiden Richard. Richard with the nice little reverse layup. Aiden Richard has great hands for a big man, and he showed some of those moves that he's got right there and puts his team up with a three-point lead now in the first quarter. Todorovic driving, finds Midland. Midland with a deep shot. That's good. His foot was on the line, and that's going to be a two-pointer. Now here's Kazeel. He tried to do a little wraparound pass there, but that's going to turn the ball over. Beasley with a no-look pass, and that's no good. Got to finish that no-look pass if you're trying to make it, and it looks like it's going to stay with First Assembly. So even though it looked like it went out of bounds on an errant pass, Gaston Day must have gotten their hands on it. And there's Midland from deep outside, and that's a good three-pointer by Charles Midland. And now his team up by two. Trevor Anderson trying to respond, but James Lewis with the rebound, and that's going to tie it up. Six all, feet inside. Here's Midland again. Up, loses the handle, and rebound by McKnight, but then he loses the ball. He gets it back over to Midland. Midland thought about a three. Step back, his foot was on the line. Shot's no good. Another rebound for Aiden Richard. Spins out of trouble, gets it up to Derek McKnight. McKnight, dangerous pass to the outside to Adam Kazeel. We got a battle inside there, and it looks like Charles Midland has come up with it. He's going to bring it up, keep it himself. A little crossover for Midland. Floater, it's out of control. And we've got another turnover. Going back to Gaston Day here. Kazeel to rebound, I mean to inbound. All knotted up here in the first quarter. And here's Anderson. Over to Lewis. Now back to McKnight. Good spacing here by First Assembly as Gaston Day is trying to find some gaps in this defense, working the ball around, trying to find some motion. There's Anderson to Lewis. Lewis looks to set a pick, but Anderson goes the other way to find Kazeel. Just no openings in that First Assembly defense right now. And there's Anderson over the top, no good. Aiden Richard with a rebound, and Aiden puts it back up and in. And that's going to put his team back up by two. Todorovic over to Wheat. Wheat fakes. Anderson closes the gap quickly, and then that makes First Assembly have to run their offense a little bit more. Inside to Nico Payne, and that shot is no good, but they're going to call goaltending. Pretty easy call there as James Lewis closed from behind and couldn't get to the ball, and that's going to give 2 points to First Assembly. Here in the first quarter, we're coming to you live from Gaston Day School. We've got several college prospects out here tonight. Another one of those guys just entered the game. That's Nate Hinton, number 10, at the bottom of your screen. Freshman for Gaston Day, gets a lot of playing time, and hopefully we'll be able to provide a spark off the bench. Another one of those college prospects is Derek McKnight here with the ball over to James Lewis. over to Pook, now down to McKnight. McKnight was looking to get the ball inside. He's covered over. Anderson's shot no good. And now here's Marquise Beasley, number five. Over to Wheat. Over to Todorovic. I'm sorry. Inside to Nico Payne. Payne unable to finish inside, but he's going to draw the foul. That's going to send him to the line, stop the clock, as we're all knotted up here in the first quarter. Nico Payne, 6'7", number 24, junior for First Assembly. Shot is no good for Payne. Shot rattled around, so hopefully he can adjust a little bit on this next shot. And rattles around and in, so perhaps a slight adjustment gives his team the lead. And now a steal. Midland up. Wild shot by Midland. And now we're going the other way. Here's McKnight. Another cross-court pass. Deep outside shot. No good. Rebound. First Assembly. Marquise Beasley up. Nice little scoop shot by Beasley. And we've really got a back-and-forth game at this point. McKnight gives it up to Hinton. James Lewis stuck out there at the top of the key. Gives it up to Trevor Anderson. He's going to hold it and wait and see what develops as Marlon Pook comes up to set the pick. Finally, Anderson waves him off. Didn't like how the defense looked there. Over to Lewis. Now to Pook. Back to Anderson. Being guarded by Matt Wheat. And there's Nate Hinton. And he drives inside and scores. And he's going to get the hoop and the harm as he scores and is going to the free throw line. So he's got a chance to earn the three-point play the old-fashioned way. Nate Hinton, the 2018 freshman shooting guard, 6'4", a really nice-looking prospect, gets a lot of playing time on this experienced Gaston Day team, a lot of seniors on this team, playing on this in the private schools in North Carolina. If you're not familiar with it, the level of basketball in the private schools is very, very good. I would say it rivals many or any of the states in the country. Indiana, high school basketball, New York, Chicago area, California, Texas, North Carolina. Those are your top schools. You got Florida in there. Those are where your hotbeds of basketball. The Georgia area, Atlanta, very strong as well. So Hinton unable to finish that three-point play in First Assembly with the ball. Beasley up, under, and no good, and there's going to be a rebound by Hinton. And he wants to push it. Doesn't slow down and tries to feed it to a teammate, and it's going to go out of bounds and turnover on going back the other way. So as the clock's winding down here, Midland, we got a three-quarter court trap here by Gaston Day. They're able to beat that. Deep outside shot, three is good. Hitting over to Lewis, now to McKnight. McKnight looking for an opening, thinks better of it, gets it over to Richard. The big men for Gaston Day definitely flashing up in that high post. Spin move by Richard and good. Beautiful looking little shot there by Aiden Richard, the 6'10" commit to Belmont Abbey. And now we've got a turnover. It's a couple of nice plays back to back here for Gaston Day as the quarter is winding down here in the first quarter. Down by two. Trevor Anderson walking the ball up. They might be playing for a single possession here. There's a steal by Charles Midland. Stops, kicks it over to Wheat. Off the side of the rim, Midland reversed by Mindland. Now Anderson. And now I definitely think they may be trying to limit the possessions here at the end of the quarter. The end of the first. All right, we're getting ready here in the second. First Assembly leading by four. You're watching Gaston Day and First Assembly. Gaston Day in the home whites and First Assembly in the dark blue away jerseys. I am Marcus Shockley with Netcast Sports, and you're watching Netcast Sports. You can watch this and all of the games at netcastsports.com. And we appreciate you joining us for this heated conference rivalry game. Charles Midland, number 14, getting ready to inbound the ball. Mindland over the top. Shot is good, and that's going to be a three-pointer. It looked like the referee wasn't aware that he was shooting. He didn't raise his hands until the end of the play there. But Mindland's had a couple of nice-looking three-pointers early, and that's given First Assembly a seven-point lead now. Here we are in the second quarter. Anderson working. Spin move by Richard that time, and he can't get it to go down. And, you know, he's got a good-looking hook shot, but that time just could not get it to go. There's Charles Mindland driving. A little bit out of control, and he loses the ball. James Lewis picks it up off the ground. Shovel pass to Aiden Richard. And they needed that. Cuts into the lead there. Stops the First Assembly run. Spin move is for Todorovic is no good. And James Lewis doing a little tightrope act there on the baseline. Gets it up to Adam Kazeel. He turns around and kicks it to Anderson. A little back and forth. And now Kazeel with a floater. And that's good. Adam Kazeel hasn't had a great shooting night, but hopefully that'll get him going. And now another turnover. And Gaston Day has a chance once again to cut into this lead. They've already cut it to three, but now there's an open court steal by Charles Mindland. Fakes up over the top, no good, and it's put back there by Todorovic. So First Assembly is not withering as Gaston Day is making a furious comeback. And we are in for a tight game here, I believe, all the way to the end of this one. Now here's number four, Derek McKnight. Over to Kazeel and over to Anderson. They're really wanting to work the ball around that perimeter. Looked like he just for a moment had Aiden Richard open, but defense closed very quickly. Here's McKnight. Shot's no good, and we're going the other way. It's First Assembly now, pushing it ahead. Nice little floater there. And I apologize to number 15. I do not have him on my roster for First Assembly. Trevor Anderson stops right above the free throw line, and that's good for Trevor Anderson. That's a deep outside shot. James Lewis able to corral that rebound. Now here's Anderson. Nice little crossover from Anderson, and he's going to draw the blocking charge, blocking foul. Huh? About combined calls there, but a blocking foul, and it's going to send Anderson to the line. He's upset with himself. He really wanted to finish that one off and get that three-point play, but he'll have to be content with taking a couple of free throws and try to cut into this five-point lead. Trevor Anderson originally had a couple of Division I offers when he was an underclassman and decided to wait. Those schools went in a different direction, so now he's wide open. A really solid guard, 6'1" senior, 6'2" rather. Shot's no good. Rebound by Hinton. Stop. And that shot is good by Nate Hinton. Steal. And score. And just like that, it's a four-point swing for Gaston Day. First Assembly kind of out of sorts here, moving the ball around, gets it over Todorovic. He goes up under and tried a nice idea with the scoop shot, but wasn't able to finish it off. And Gaston Day thinks they had the turnover, but no good. And looks like First Assembly's going to keep it there. That's probably good for them. They a little out of sorts on those last couple of plays, and hopefully this will help them get a set play coming in as they inbound the ball. Inside, nice. Wild shot, though, and battle between Hinton and Todorovic. And Gaston Day gets the better of that one. And here's Derek McKnight working against Marquise Beasley. Pulls it back, beats Beasley off the dribble, but can't score. And now we're going the other way. Here's Matt Wheat. Over to Payne, now moves it over to number 15, who I apologize, I don't have his name on the roster. Here's Payne underneath, and nice little drop step there by Payne, but wasn't able to finish the play once he got underneath. Steal by Wheat, but then Hinton gets it back, unable to score, and that's going to be another foul and a chance for a three-point play here for Gaston Day, as the tide is definitely turning here in the second quarter for Gaston Day. That's going to send number 32, 6'6" sophomore Marlon Pook to the line. Pook's shot is no good. Three-pointer, that's a deep three-pointer there. McKnight to Kazeel. Just not finding the range tonight for Kazeel thus far. Normally he's a very gifted sharpshooter. And that one's short, rebounded by Pook. A lot of sloppy play here. James Lewis tries to clean it up, and he does. As both teams go back and forth. Just nobody really able to get set and find a good shot, and there's going to be a foul on the floor here. Wheat's shot is short and tried to save the ball there for First Assembly and wasn't able to do so. And so Gaston Day is So we've got a break on the floor. Once again, you're watching Gaston Day and First Assembly here on netcastsports.com. I am Marcus Shockley with Netcast Sports, and we appreciate everyone joining us. We're going to take a quick break here as the teams have a timeout on the floor. Coming back here, get ready to inbound for Gaston Day. Adam Kazeel will be inbounding it, looks like, to Derek McKnight here. Charles Midland has been picking up McKnight at full court quite a bit, and it looks like they're going with a three-quarter trap here again, First Assembly. Midland. No good, but put it back up and in. That trap worked well last time, so they're going to try it again. Now here's Hinton. Really wanted to go towards the basket and then lost the handle. Had to slow up. And First Assembly trying to play some smothering defense back here. And McKnight in danger of going over the half-court line, but doesn't. Very heady point guard, McKnight, Derek McKnight. That's going the other way. Good defense there by First Assembly. And they're going to be rewarded with a possession. Here's Marquise Beasley. Feet inside. Nice little spin move by Midland, but he can't finish it off. But then rebound and put back. Oh, and that's going to be a push. Right at midcourt. Probing the defense and then decides to pull it out. Kazeel. First Assembly really extending their defense right now, and Gaston Day showing poise and patience trying to probe that defense. So both teams kind of playing a little bit of chess here. Anderson finds Hinton. Hinton did get inside, but his shot is blocked, put back up by Lewis, and that's going to score, James Lewis. Lewis has a couple of Division I offers as well, the 6'8" big man, junior. James Lewis started at center tonight for Gaston Day. Here's Midland up and under and score. That's going to send Charles Midland to the line. And we talked about Charles Midland earlier in the broadcast. He's sort of a combo guard forward. He's not a combo guard. He's more of a guard forward, shooting guard, small forward. Probably looks like he might play more shooting guard at the college level. Has 12 reported Division I offers as of tonight, and several more colleges being interested in him, including Rutgers and Butler, who's in the building tonight. UNC Greensboro, College of Charleston. Thank you. All right, we're back here for the third quarter here in Gaston-Day. Gaston-Day School First Assembly on the road taking on Gaston-Day. So far, First Assembly has gotten the better of the game, but it's been tied all the way. And we are getting ready to start the third quarter as Adam Kazeel is poised and ready to inbound the ball. You're watching tonight's broadcast on Netcast Sports. I am Marcus Shockley of Netcast Sports. You can follow Netcast Sports at Netcast Sports on Twitter. You can watch this and all of the replays, upcoming games and replays, online at netcastsports.com. So Gaston-Day looking to work around. First Assembly's had good defense. Overall, I would say tonight's game has been pretty sloppy, generally in offensive execution, but these teams are both fighting tooth and nail. They're still in it, and there's a score inside as Gaston-Day eats into that lead. Now there's Minland, and he's going to lose the ball. Here's Derek McKnight. Finds Kazeel in the corner. Over to Hinton. Nate Hinton, the freshman, getting a lot of playing time tonight. Over to James Lewis, the big man. Hinton drives, lost his footing. They're going to call a foul. A lot of First Assembly fans aren't happy with that call. I believe that call is going to be on the floor and not in the act of shooting, so Gaston-Day will be inbounding. We're here in the third quarter. And another turnover. I would have to say that tonight's game has been relatively sloppy overall. A lot of something the coaches will probably talk to them about. It's good to see the game tight, but definitely some areas for improvement for both these teams, especially on the offensive end. Now Minland gets in trouble out there, and he wants to give the ball up. Gives it up to Wheat. Wheat shot up and looked like it was going to go down, but did not. Aiden Richard with yet another rebound, but a wild pass by Richard is thrown away, and that's another deep three. And the three-point shot can clean up a lot of messes when it's falling, and right there, that's definitely something that First Assembly is happy with. Over the top to Lewis, and Lewis gets caught up in the air, and I believe that's going to be a travel. No, they're going to call a jump ball. And at the high school level, I have to agree with my friend James Blackburn. We would rather call that a possession ball because there is no real jump ball at the high school or college level. Possession arrow with First Assembly, so that's where we're going. Here in the third quarter, shot by Minland. Nice-looking floater there, mid-range shot by Minland. Saw that a lot from him in the NC Top 80 back in March. Really showed an ability to find that gap in the defense and knock it down. Adam Kazeel with the fadeaway jumper. And as I said earlier, Kazeel hasn't been able to find the range, but he squares up really well in his shot and often can be relied on for those big buckets, and there he gets a steal up and under, and just like that, back-to-back Kazeel with four quick points. Now Wheat again, kind of an early shot there. Aiden Richard able to get another rebound. They're going the other way, but sloppy play from both teams is just a turnover fest at this point, and the turnover fest continues. And now here's Aiden Richard. He gets a steal while lying on the floor. And Derek McKnight decides he's seen enough, and he decides to slow it down right there in front of his own bench. Gets it up to Hinton. Nate Hinton loses his dribble, picked up by Kazeel. Oh, Kazeel is really feeling it now. He's a one-man scoring machine as he's pulled Gaston Day all the way back into this. So here in the third. Been tight, back and forth throughout this game. No change here. Looked like there for a moment early in the third. Looked like First Assembly was going to pull away, but now Gaston Day's clawed all the way back into it. And we're right back neck and neck here. Derek McKnight. And that's going to be a blocking foul on the floor, and I believe it's going to send number three, Matt Wheat, back to the line. The 6'1" senior, Matt Wheat, second leading scorer on the team. Substitutions here for both teams. Richard turned from that high post and tried to feed it inside to the low post to James Lewis, and it's battered around there, and it looks like it's going to stay with Gaston Day. Lewis inbounding up over the top to 6'10" Aiden Richard, but even then Richard had to use his entire height to pull that ball in, but Gaston Day keeps it. Here's Lewis driving, spinning. Good defense there by Payne. Lewis keeps his footing, keeps his head, and goes up and under and scores. Great patience there by James Lewis, the 6'8" junior for Gaston Day. One thing I really like to see here is both teams are fired up, but Gaston Day, I think they have a little bit more urgency, at least at this state of the game. Crowd's not as big as what we saw a week ago with Northside Christian. You can see on the far side of the gym, you can see that the bleachers are not pulled out. Everybody's on one side. So a slightly smaller crowd tonight, but the urgency is definitely there for both of these teams. And right now, I think Gaston Day is just a little bit quicker, but you know, the score is tight, and either team could take it, so we'll see who gets the better of it. Kind of a sloppy game, but both teams trying to figure out who can exert their will here as we finish up the third, going into the fourth. Over the top and good by Nico Payne, number 24. We've got a timeout on the floor. Want to let everybody know that February 3rd we'll be broadcasting at Calvary Day School, and they'll be taking on their rival High Point Christian Academy. Had a close loss to High Point Christian at HPCA just about a week or so ago. A great game coming up, a lot of college players in that game as well, so I hope you'll join us February 3rd on netcastsports.com at 7 p.m. Calvary Baptist versus High Point Christian Academy. But we're back here live with Gaston Day in First Assembly. Trevor Anderson inside to Lewis. Back out to Anderson. And he's being guarded by Matt Weed, as he has been most of the night. Deep outside shot by Anderson off the front of the rim. And looks like we've got a jump ball, or as I like to call it, a possession ball, as I said earlier. And this time that possession ball is going to go in Gaston Day's favor. Lewis battling in there, and good defense by First Assembly as they come up with a turnover. I would say it's safe to say at this point that neither team has been able to establish themselves and exert their will. And right now it's definitely anybody's ball game. Anderson to inbound to McKnight. Two seniors here in the backcourt. Anderson and McKnight play together most of their career here at Gaston Day. Either player here can bring the ball up. McKnight more of the true point guard, whereas Anderson is more of a combo guard, can run the point, but also an excellent scorer. And he shows right there some nice passing moves, and he gets the ball to Pook, but that's going to be waved off, and we're going the other way. So hit a real slump here in scoring for both teams in the third quarter. And it's going to be a travel call. McKnight's shown the ability to break that press all by himself at times. There's Kazeel. Shot no good. Ball battled around. Ends up in the hands of Nico Payne, I believe. Now here's Matt Wheat. Launching it from outside. No good. Kazeel coming up with the rebound. Feed underneath. No good. Put back up by Lewis. James Lewis once again cleaning up a lot. We finally get some scoring back in the game here. Good defense there by Lewis on Nico Payne, and it ends up resulting in a turnover. That turnover was started by Lewis's excellent hands. Deep shot, good by Kazeel. And that's going to send us to a timeout. We'll be back in just a moment. We're back here for the fourth quarter, and I have to apologize to guys here. The crew were giving me a hard time because I said we were going to a timeout when we were actually at the end of the quarter. So we're getting ready to start the fourth quarter in just a moment. We've had some audio and video difficulties tonight, and hopefully we've gotten those straightened out. And I do apologize for that. Here's Wheat. So now it looks like First Assembly trying to be more patient on the offensive end. Matt Wheat going against Adam Kazeel. Now here's Charles Midland. Midland working against Derek McKnight. Steal in the open court there by and that's going to end the third. I'm looking at my crew. I've got so much going on here, I'm not paying attention to the clock correctly. But anyway, I apologize. That's the end of the third, and we'll be back in just a few minutes with the fourth. Getting ready to inbound here. 44-40. Favor of Gaston Day. Aiden Richard got into trouble there. Kicks it way out to Kazeel, and that shot is good. And they're going to give him a three. Looked like a little delay there in the referee. Right now, Gaston Day definitely biggest lead of the ball game for Gaston Day over First Assembly. Charles Midland trying to draw the foul, and I think he does so. Charles Midland, number 14. 6'4" shooting guard. And that shot is good, and that's going to be another three. Lewis to Richard. Richard wasn't quite sure if he wanted to shoot that one, I think. Once again, I apologize for the video and audio difficulties we had earlier tonight. We had some clock issues. We lost our clock. And hopefully we're all caught up and everything's looking good. Deep outside shot, no good. But one thing that's for certain is this game is going to go down to the wire. It has gone down to the wire here in the fourth. Now here's Derek McKnight. This matchup between McKnight and Charles Midland has been really fun to watch all night, even though the play overall from both teams has been somewhat sloppy. Now here's Charles Minley. He's going to be running the point for this possession, or at least kicking it off. Right now, looks like Gaston Day trying to run up some trap there. Inside to Midland, shot, no good, battle, and Gaston Day coming up with it. Now they want to run. McKnight up over the top, beautiful shot there by Derek McKnight. You can tell that the Gaston Day faithful are feeling it. Wheat really takes those deep shots. That's about the third or fourth one we've seen him take from NBA level. Now McKnight with a little mid-range, no good. There's going to be a push inside. Midland for three, and that's good. Charles Midland keeping his team close. McKnight. McKnight has an extremely quick crossover, and he has that ability to beat his defender and get inside. And right there, he actually drew the foul, and he's going to be going to the line. So a couple of points there at the line for Derek McKnight, and that helps keep the lead for Gaston Day. They really have to feel good about where they are right at the moment here in the fourth. But Charles Midland isn't giving up that easy, and he slides into the defense and scores. And then tough defense out there by Midland, but ended up falling to the floor. And we've got another foul in the paint there, and that's, I don't think that was a shooting foul. And it looks like they're going to be inbounding it under the basket. First Assembly looking for some answers, and Gaston Day really pumped. And I said this earlier in the broadcast that it looks like Gaston Day is just a little bit more motivated for this win, a little bit more jazz coming in with the conference leader on their home floor. But this game is by no means over. A lot of time left in this one. Nate Hinton now. He gets it up to McKnight. McKnight turns, gives it up to Kazeel. Midland is chasing McKnight. Deep outside shot is good, and that's going to be a three. Now Midland, he wants to equal another three for Charles Midland. McKnight slices all the way under the defense and kicks it outside. The net three is no good. Rebound by number 44, Milo Stevanovic. Midland for three again. And that shot is off, but he's going to go for the line, and I believe he's going to be shooting three. Could not ask for anything better for First Assembly, stopping the clock, stopping some of this Gaston Day momentum, and putting their leading scorer on the line for three shots. Can't get the first one to go down, however. Midland having a nice scoring night tonight. He's really kept his team in it here in the second half. Aiden Richards slides up or under the defense there, but good defense recovery by Midland and Nico Payne. Now here's Midland in the open court. And almost lost the ball. Shot no good. Rebounded by Kazeel. Pushes way up. Oh, and that's going to be goaltending now. On the other side. So we had a goaltending call go against Gaston Day in the first half, and now we've had a goaltending call go against First Assembly here in the second. Matt Wheat with the ball working against Trevor Anderson. it looks like we have a timeout on the floor as First Assembly was completely out of sorts. So we'll be back in just a moment. All right, we're back. Gaston Day still pumped. They have a slim lead here in the fourth. See if they can pull it out or First Assembly can cut this lead. And here's the guy they want to drive it through. Well, Charles Menland and, of course, number three there, Matt Wheat, also with the ball. Both of these guys can score and would be their first option. And he tried, and you know, Wheat tried to get it to Menland, but pass was cut off there by Lewis, but it's going to stay with First Assembly. No good. Rebounded by Aiden Richard. He's going to give it up to Trevor Anderson, who's now running the point. Anderson, a strong guard, physically strong, running the point. He gets it over to Nate Hinton, who we've seen has that slashing ability. And there's going to be a foul way out on the floor. Nowhere near a shooting foul yet. First Assembly with the rebound. Now here's Menland. Stop. Shoots the three. And that's short. Big rebound there for Gaston Day. And that's going to be Derek McKnight, who's gotten a ton of rebounds. Beautiful pass by Derek McKnight. No look under the basket. Just gorgeous. And that, not only, it's only one assist in the book, but that assist is one of the best we've seen in a while. And that increases the lead. And now right back comes First Assembly. Not going anywhere. And we've got a timeout on the floor as both coaches want to talk things over, no doubt. We'll be back in just a moment. Want to remind everybody that you're watching Gaston Day and First Assembly live from Gastonia, North Carolina, and at Gaston Day School. Gaston Day School is in the home whites. First Assembly are in the away dark blue jerseys. I am Marcus Shockley with Netcast Sports, and we appreciate everyone joining us tonight. And you can watch this replay and all of our upcoming broadcasts on netcastsports.com. You can also follow us on Twitter at Netcast Sports. Coming up February 3rd, we have Calvary Baptist and High Point Christian at Calvary Baptist. That's a conference matchup. And February 10th, we have Winston-Salem Prep and North Surrey. So I hope you'll tune in for both of those matchups. A lot of college prospects. So many college prospects between tonight's game and those two games that I encourage any fan or recruiting fan or college to tune in. And here's McKnight up and under. And McKnight looked like he was going to pull that off, wasn't able to do so. And now here's First Assembly. Marquise Beasley, number five, back in the game, running the point for First Assembly. And there's a steal. by Nate Hinton with the dunk. A little rim grazer of a dunk, but it's a dunk all the same, and really matters is it's 2 points and extends that lead. So now First Assembly really, Marquise Beasley really coming close to that half court line, but First Assembly's got to come up with something, and there's a huge steal now for Gaston Day. There's a block, nice defensive recovery for First Assembly. And I believe that's going to stay with First Assembly. Midland to inbound, Charles Midland. And yeah, and right now, definitely want to talk things over on the First Assembly side as they are trailing with almost no time here. Very, very little time left in the game. You're watching Gaston Day and First Assembly, and we'll be back in just a moment. Not a lot of time left here in this game, so First Assembly has to be thinking about their options. This entire second half for First Assembly, their scoring has predominantly come from one player, and that's been Charles Midland. An athletic guard forward that so many colleges are interested in, but you know, they really need some of their other players maybe to move and help Midland out here, and they've got to have more balanced scoring, at least at this stage in the game. And here's one of those players that may be able to provide that, Matt Wheat. But this entire game has been, the first half was sloppier than the second, but you'd have to say that Gaston Day has been a little bit quicker to the ball overall. And there's a, once again, an example of that is Derek McKnight gets his hands on the ball. And McKnight has had an outstanding second half. Really solid point guard from Derek McKnight. I don't know what his college outlook looks like, but I've always liked his crossover. I believe he has one of the quickest crossovers in the state, possibly the Southeast. Seen a lot of players over the past 15 years, 20 years, and right now at the high school level in this region, I think Derek McKnight is one of the more underrated point guards. Uncommitted senior, number four, right there with the ball. And now he's got to beat the press, and does. And that's one of the things I really like about